becomes stable. Also, since we are reducing the type, so reducing type will increase the steady state error, because for higher order system, higher type systems, the steady state error is less. So what we are doing here is we are introducing a zero at origin. So we are introducing a zero at origin, and introduction of that zero is making a system stable, but also it is reducing the type of system. So stability is increased. Stability is increased, but the ESS, it increases. In the previous case, what was happening? The steady state error was decreasing, but the stable system was becoming an unstable. Let us consider the same example again. So without controller, if I consider g of s is equal to 1 by s square into s plus 10. This is without controller. Then this is a type 2 system. Type of the system is 2, and the characteristic equation of this system is s cube plus 10s square plus 1 equal to 0. This is the characteristic equation. Now with controller, the transfer function will become kd into s. So s and s will can cancel, so I'll get s into s plus 10. So this is with controller. So now what will happen? We are reducing the type of the system. The type of the system is, type is equal to 1, and the characteristic equation of the system is, characteristic equation is s square plus 10s plus kd equal to 0. So here this system is unstable, whereas this system will be stable, because here all the powers of s are present, whereas here s power 1 is missing. But also we have reduced the type by 1. Here the system was type 2, and here the type system is type 1. So what we can conclude from this is, we are making a system stable, that is, we are increasing the stability, but also we are increasing the steady state error by the introduction of derivative controller. Next we will introduce PI controller. Now for PI controller and PD controller, we need not study too much, because we have already seen the controller separately. So PI controller, now this kind of, what was happening with integral controller? With integral controller, the steady state error was reducing, but the system was becoming unstable. Now PI controller, what it will do is, it will decrease ESS. It will decrease ESS because we are introducing a integral controller without affecting stability. This is the advantage of this. It will not affect the stability. Without affecting stability, it reduces the ESS. And what about PD controller? So PD controller, it makes the system stable without affecting steady state error now. So it is used to improve stability. So stability will be improved without affecting ESS. So these are the advantage of PI controller and PD controller. So the disadvantage of integral controller is removed using PI controller, as well as the introduction of proportional controller along with derivative controller. It also avoids the disadvantage of derivative controller. So therefore, the disadvantages of individual controller, that is the integral controller and derivative controller, can be removed. Okay, so the transfer function of PI controller will be, the transfer function will be Kp plus Ki by S, and the transfer function of PD controller will be Kp plus Kd into S. Now if I multiply this, I'll get S Kp plus Ki by S, and here I'll get Kp plus Kd into S. So no change. So what we are doing here is, we are adding a finite a pole at origin, as well as we are adding a finite zero. So what will happen? This finite zero, this finite pole, this what it will do? It will increase the type of the system, and hence the steady state error will be reduced. So this will reduce the ESS. ESS will be reduced by using this finite, this pole at origin. Whereas this finite zero, this will not allow the system to affect the, this will not allow the controller to affect the stability. So it will stop affecting the stability. So in this way, we observe that the introduction of proportional controller along with integral controller removes the disadvantage of integral controller alone. Now, let me consider this with the example again. So the example here will be, again I'll take the same example, 1 by s into s plus 10. So this is type 1 system. The system is of type 1. And the characteristic equation is s square plus 10s plus 1 equal to 0. This system is stable. Now, if I introduce the controller, so with controller, this will be g of s is equal to s into kp plus ki divided by s square into s plus 10. So this is type 2 system, and the characteristic equation here will be s cube plus 10s square plus kp into s plus ki equal to 0. So what is happening here? The system will remain stable even after applying the controller. So what we have done? We have increased the type of the system. So therefore, this will reduce the steady state error, and also the stability is not affected. Similarly, for PD controller, we can do it. The same example can be carried out for PD controller also. Okay. Next. Finally, the PID controller. Okay, so PID controller. Now, PID controller, what will PID controller do? So, the purpose of PID controller is it improves stability. To improve stability, so it improves stability as well as ESS is decreased. So this is the advantage of this. It improves stability as well as it improves steady state error. Here the transfer function will be kp plus ki by s plus kd into s, and this can be understood with the same example again. So in this way, we have studied all the types of controllers, and we observe that PID controller is the best one, but it increases the hardware of the system. So with this, we finish the course of control systems. Becomes stable. Also.